students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and you are revising whatever is taught to you. Okay, today we'll continue with the same chapter, that is life processes. It's a long chapter, students, and today we will discuss about human digestive system. In the previous class we discussed about holozoic nutrition, we discussed about complex nutrients and the simple nutrients and why the complex nutrients are converted into simple nutrients. Please open page number 99 of your NCERT book. Now, human digestive system. Human digestive system, it consists of a series of organs, okay, or a group of organs and associated glands, okay, which take parts in ingestion, crushing, digestion, absorption and ejection of food materials. As you have as we discussed in the previous class, that the holozoic nutrition has different processes, that is intake of food is called ingestion, digestion, absorption and ejection. So digestive system consists of different organs and all these processes take part in these organs, okay, and also the digestive glands. These digestive glands secrete some juices which take part, which helps in the process of digestion, okay. Now please see here, digestive system consists of two parts. Please see, students, alimentary canal and digestive glands. Alimentary canal and digestive glands. What is the alimentary canal? Alimentary canal is a long coiled muscular and tubular passage, okay, which extends from mouth to anus. You can see in your books also, see here this, okay. So this is a long tube, you can see in this diagram. It is a long tube, okay, it is a long tube, you can see, which extends from mouth, this long tube, till anus. I hope it is clear. Or you can see here also, this whole is digestive system. From mouth till anus, this is called as alimentary canal. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now this alimentary canal, it consists of organs like mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine, okay. And the digestive glands, here digestive glands associated with digestive system include salivary glands, liver and pancreas. I hope it is clear. So digestive gland consists of alimentary canal and the digestive glands. Now alimentary canal, you can see here, alimentary canal consists of different organs. And what are those different organs? You can see here these different organs. Here you can see mouth, esophagus, stomach, this is small intestine and this is large intestine. I hope it is clear to everyone. This is a digestive gland, liver. Here, can you see here, very very fine, just see in your book, this is pancreas. And here there are salivary glands. I will show you in this picture. You can see these are the salivary glands, okay, in the near the in the mouth region. Here, if this is mouth, here on either side these are the salivary glands, okay. This is liver, which is another gland. And can you see this? This is pancreas, okay. So this is stomach, esophagus, this is small intestine and this is large intestine. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now students, let us read from, we eat various type of food which has to pass through the same digestive tract. Naturally the food has to be processed to generate particles which are small and to the same texture. This is achieved by crushing the food with our teeth. Since the lining of the canal is soft, the food is also wetted to make the passage smooth. When we eat something, we like our mouth waters. This is actually not only waters but a fluid called saliva secreted by salivary glands. Another aspect of the food we ingest is its complex nature. If it is to be absorbed from the alimentary canal, it has to be broken into smaller molecules. This is done with the help of biological catalyst called as enzymes. The saliva contains an enzyme called salivary amylase. Please underline that breaks down starch, which is a complex molecule, to give sugar. The food is mixed thoroughly with saliva and moved around the mouth while chewing with the muscular tongue. Now, first part of the alimentary canal is mouth. I have told you this before also, number of times also. The food has to reach the cell, and the blood is the medium which carries the food to the cell. But big particles of food cannot be transported or absorbed by the blood. For that, the food particles has to be converted into smaller and smaller pieces. And the nutrients also, when we eat the food is present. Food, actually the nutrients are present in a complex form. Okay, and that cannot be absorbed by the blood. So it has to be converted into the simple one so that it can be absorbed by the blood. So the main aim in the digestive system in the different organs is that they break the food into, or the nutrients into, simpler substances. Understood? Now students, when we eat the food, okay, first process of holozoic nutrition is ingestion. So when you eat the food, okay, in humans, the ingestion, it takes place in the mouth. Okay, here in the mouth food enters. Now I have told you this before also, that there are two types of breakdown of food. One is mechanically, where the big solid pieces of food is broken into smaller and smaller and smaller. Another one is the nutrient breakdown. Okay, that is the nutrients, the complex nutrients like carbohydrate, proteins, fats, they are broken into, or they are converted into simpler form. Now mechanical breakdown of food, that is pieces of food, big pieces of food that is converted into semi-liquid form, that is done by the help of teeth, the muscles of the stomach. Okay, and the nutrient breakdown, that is done by the help of enzymes. By the help of what? Enzymes. What are enzymes? First of all, what are enzymes? Please see in your book here. Enzymes are biological catalysts. What do you mean by biological catalyst? What is a catalyst? Catalyst, in chemistry you must have studied, catalyst are those substances which increases the rate of reaction, or which helps the reaction to occur. Okay, if the reaction is slow, with the help of the catalyst, the rate of reaction, it increases. Okay, so these enzymes are called as biological catalyst. Why? Because it operates in the biological system. That is why it is called as enzymes. So enzymes are biological catalyst. What are catalyst? Which increases the rate of reaction, or with which helps in the occurrence of chemical reaction. So they are the catalyst. But why biological catalyst? Because it helps, or it functions in the biological system. I hope it is clear. What do you mean by enzymes? Enzymes are what? Enzymes are biological catalyst. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now this is about enzymes. So now students, what happens? These enzymes, okay, these enzymes help in the nutrient breakdown of food. The nutrients of the food that is broken down with the help of enzymes, which are the biological catalysts. Okay, so different type of nutrients like carbohydrate, proteins, fats, they are broken by enzymes. Which enzyme? Not the same enzymes, but the different enzymes like carbohydrates. Okay, so like carbohydrates like starch is a complex carbohydrate, like carbohydrates, which is a starch, that is broken down by an enzyme which is called as amylase. Understood? Everyone has understood? So carbohydrates are converted or broken down or digested with the help of an enzyme called as amylase. Another complex nutrient is proteins. Proteins are digested with the help of enzyme called as pepsin and trypsin. Understood or no? And then another nutrient is fats. So fats is a complex nutrient. So this fat is converted into the simpler form, but how it is converted? This is a nutrient. So these nutrients like carbohydrate, proteins and fats cannot be converted into simple form by chewing it with the, or by crushing it with the teeth, or by contraction of the stomach muscles. This teeth or the muscular contraction of the stomach can only digest or can only break the bigger food particles, but not the nutrients. For nutrient digestion like carbohydrates, proteins and fats, what is needed? Enzymes are needed, and enzymes are called as biocatalyst. Understood or no? Now students, like there is a fixed key for each lock, same way there is a fixed enzyme for each nutrient. Understood? Now the lock cannot be opened by any key. There is a fixed key that can only open the lock. So same way here also, these amylases, okay, these amylases are the they are the enzymes which break or which act only and only on carbohydrates. This amylase can digest or break only carbohydrate, but not the proteins. Protein digestion is brought about by enzymes which are called as pepsins and trypsins. So when these enzymes, they act on proteins, which is a complex nutrient, then only proteins can be digested. Now these pepsin can not act on carbohydrate, it cannot act on fat, but it can act on only proteins. Or proteins cannot be digested by amylase or by any other enzyme, but it can be digested only by pepsin and trypsin. So this is specific. Okay, these enzymes, pepsin and trypsin, if this enzyme is present and if the food contains, suppose, only carbohydrate, then carbohydrate will not be broken down by pepsin or trypsin. But if amylase is present, then it can be broken down by amylase. I hope it is clear. So fats, which is a complex nutrient, can only be digested by lipases. So if you remember these enzymes, I think you have understood everything, or this digestive system has become much easier for you. So amylase acts on carbohydrates, which are sugars. Pepsin and trypsin acts on proteins, and lipase acts on fats. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now please come to the, just please refer this diagram. Now students, ingestion takes place in mouth. So when the food enters the mouth, the food is crushed by the teeth as well as by the tongue. So what happens here, just near the ears, okay, on the sides of both the sides of the face here, okay, you can see in this picture, these are certain glands which are called as salivary glands. So when you eat the food, suddenly food becomes wet. Why it becomes wet? Because when the food enters the mouth, this is a ingestion, okay, takes place in mouth. So when the food enters the mouth, some watery substance which is called as saliva, that is secreted by the glands, salivary glands, which is located on either side of the mouth, okay, and this saliva, it enters here in the mouth and it makes the food wet. I hope it is clear to everyone. And when you think now you can do this, you think about some tasty food, suddenly the your mouth will start watering. So what is that water? That water is actually the saliva, which is secreted by these glands called as salivary glands. Understood? So when you eat the food, or when we eat the food, the first of all food. So that food which we eat, that food is rich in different types of nutrients. That food has carbohydrates also, has proteins also, has fats also. Okay, so all the nutrients are present in a complex form, and these nutrients in different parts of the digestive system needs to be digested, needs to be broken down. And I told you this thing, this nutrient digestion or breakdown is brought about by enzymes which are specific for each nutrient. I hope it's clear to everyone. So when you eat food, then with the help of tongue or with the help of the teeth, the food is broken. You know this thing. And then it is mixed with saliva, the food, it is wet and it becomes soft, so for the easy swallowing of the food. I hope it's clear to everyone. Now students, in saliva there is one enzyme which is called salivary amylase. Another name is also tylin. Another name of salivary amylase is also tylin. This salivary amylase, this is salivary amylase, or it is also called as, understood. Now one more thing I would like to tell you, wherever you come across this word amylase, not necessary, it's a salivary amylase means it's present in some amylase, or wherever you come across this term amylase, means that carbohydrate digestion has taken place or will take place, or it will digest carbohydrate. If you come across, if I say that in stomach there is an enzyme in stomach, gastric juice is secreted which contains the enzyme pepsin. Sorry. So automatically which nutrient is digested? Proteins are digested. Understood? So here this salivary amylase is present, and food which we eat contains different types of nutrients. So can any one of you tell me this amylase now will digest, or which nutrient is digested in the mouth? Please send me the answer in the WhatsApp fast, without wasting time, don't read anything. So amylase, which nutrient is digested in the mouth? Okay, so just send the answer to me, and today we will do till here. Next we will do in next class. Okay, and I hope you are understanding. So please read on your own also, for have a better understanding. Thank you, students.